ESN-TV coverage of the 12th Annual Consortium for School Networking Conference is sponsored by Smart Technologies, N Computing, and CCC Video on Demand, in cooperation with Cable in the Classroom and Consortium for School Networking.
I'm here with Helen Soulet, who is the Executive Director of Cable in the Classroom. Helen, why don't you start off by just telling us a little bit about what Cable in the Classroom is and what your mission is.
Sure. Thank you for having me here. Cable in the Classroom is the cable industry's education foundation. We were founded in 1989, so almost 20 years ago, and our mission is really to enhance and support learning, teaching and learning using media and technology.
And you also provide services to schools free of charge, copyright-free content and so on. Can you talk about that a little bit?
Sure. One of the core commitments for Cable in the Classroom that began at its inception in 1989 and continues today is that cable provides free access to cable for schools. So in every community where their cable is located, there is a free cable drop into that school. And in addition to that, there is over 500 hours of copyright-cleared, commercial-free programming that teachers can use in their classrooms.
Who are some of your members, and what sorts of outreach efforts do you do in that area?
Sure. Our members are the cable operators, so those are the people who provide your cable into your home and also provide your internet and maybe even your phone, and also the cable programmers. So our members are very varied. We also have the cable equipment providers are also some of our members.
I understand that you're embarking on a media literacy campaign. Can you tell us a little bit about that?
Sure. One of the things that we've been interested in at Cable in the Classroom for a very long time is media literacy, making sure that students and children and parents understand how to analyze and evaluate media in any form. As the internet has come to be a very part of the fabric of our lives, we have moved into the internet safety and literacy area because we think that it's really very important for students to be safe online, but also to be smart about what they see and what they do online. So we've embarked on an initiative to help that. It has many components to it, but certainly an outreach campaign, an awareness piece to it so that we can heighten awareness of parents and educators. And then we also have a community event piece to it so that people will know and can do events in their local school districts or libraries or community centers.
How would you define media literacy and what sorts of resources are you including to help teach what that is and help educators teach that to their students?
Media literacy is a term that kind of means different things to different people, but the experts will probably not think that I have defined it correctly, but in my view, a media literacy is really the ability to understand and analyze and evaluate media in any of its forms that come to you, whether it be on the web or across your cable line or just even in a film. And some of the initiatives that we will undertake is we will be out in communities doing workshops with our local cable operators. We will be developing a navigating guide for parents to this Web 2.0. It'll be a report that'll be available online and in paper. We will be doing some podcasts and maybe we're even talking about doing some things like having a local town hall meetings and working with other community partners that have resources.
And I understand that you also just recently launched a blog for educators.
Yes, we just launched, really it's a podcast channel. We call it Kids Cable Learning, which is also our tagline, shockingly. We have over about 55 different podcasts on that channel. Everything from LeVar Burton, who is the star of Roots, has done a podcast for us. that we're very proud of that talks about why he did Roots and why it's important to education. We also have several other of the Cable in the Classroom programming stars that have done. Linda Ellery has a podcast up there, and she's done a lot of work in internet safety, and so she has one up there. We also have our Leaders in Learning Award winners, who are the people who have won awards from us in the past, and they are educators who are leading the way doing cutting-edge things in school districts. And so we've interviewed each of them about their projects that they won an award for, and those are up there. So I would encourage people to go to that channel. It's available on iTunes or on our website, and listen to some of those podcasts, because they're fascinating, and they're not very long, so it doesn't take very long. It's one of the beauties of podcasts. But they're also varying topics, too.
At the roundtable discussion that COSEN convened for its 15th year anniversary, you made an interesting point about how quickly technology is changing and what challenges that presents for educators. Can you talk about that a little bit?
Sure, I'd be glad to. I think that in this Web 2.0, we are embarking on a time when innovation and creativity is just being expanded at such a rate that the devices we use, the applications on the devices, the content forms, all of that are changing at a pace that educators find hard to keep up with. I think if we focus on that it is really about the content and not about the device it's on, that we can feel better about it and not worry so much about the technology that's around it. Because the kids don't care what the technology is. They're going to just embrace it and use it and then toss it away for the newest thing. And so I think it's an education for educators, but I think they have to keep their kind of eye on the ball around the content and the curriculum and not worry so much about the technology.